past the hour. Jason, what's going on, brother?
Netflix, man, you're killing it there before the break. I mean, that is a big one this week.
There's no doubt, man.
Only on Wall Street, sorry, I didn't want to cut you off, but only on Wall Street, you know, everybody reads whatever they can prepare, and, you know, I'm going through stuff, is now the consensus expectation is for an upside surprise on the consensus expectation. You know, it's like, what a beautiful world when, like, the expectation is that it's going to be above the expectation, right? Like, it's kind of, it's a Wall Street special today. If I'm on Netflix, though, I am biting my nails right now.
There's no doubt, man. I mean, there's no doubt. It's been the expansion in price has been about as dramatic as you can get.
That's right. I mean, they were 320s coming into the year, right? It's a lot of us have kind of a pre-virus, post-virus, you know, like what they've done since the virus. But, I mean, stable state, 320 coming into the year. Certainly the virus has helped the stay-at-home stocks. But, you know, Disney Plus is rocketed well past expectations. And It's hard to make a case that that's a net positive for Netflix over the long term, especially with pervasive unemployment.
Yeah, and you know, it's so intriguing what you just said, and I know that this is what the equities have done. So picture this, folks. We have a tremendous economy before COVID, right? And what
that's right.
has happened here is that now we're in the middle of this, and yet Netflix is almost twice the price.
That's right, right? Like, we had record employment, right. Good economy coming into 2020, and they're 320, right? Okay.
Yeah.
You know, and suddenly global health pandemic, and, you know, they're 570, you know, or they got up to 570, clearly.
Oh, yeah, 575. Okay.
And
well,
by the way,
since we're talking about that, I got to give you the ultimate rocket ship. I mean, I got your ultimate rocket ship here, man. It's Elon Musk and Tesla, man.
I mean, we've all been wrong on Musk plenty of times, and I'm certainly as many as others, but I want to do some math for you. I mean, clearly the melt up. I mean, it looks like a Bitcoin chart. Everybody's aware of, but you know, when you look at the probabilities, you know, we're at an 80% probability of a 40% drop just based on historicals.
Yeah.
I mean, anything can happen. Musk could continue to do it. It's another good example, though. I mean, that's not even a stay-at-home stock. That is just clear, you know, what the kids call FOMO or fear of missing out. I mean, that's just a bubble, man. There's no basis for that.
They've
had interruptions.
Out. Yeah, fear of missing out, man. Wait till they find out what a real correction is, man.
It's just all, you know, it moves fast on you, too. And the unfortunate part, or, you know, it is what it is, you know, Robinhood's done a lot of stuff for the space, in a sense, and democratizing access. You know. But when every day, you know, I look at the leaderboard, top 10 stocks being traded on Robinhood, and a lot of those are your more inexperienced traders, and they're holding a lot of Tesla.
They are.
You know, because those platforms now allow you to hold fractional shares even, right? So, you know, you can hold a part of a share.
Right.
Given the share price, right, it's not as accessible. But, you know, so folks will hold parts of shares. And, you know, every day it's like 10,000. I read some stat the other day. I'm not going to get this exactly right. But something like 10,000 new traders hit the Robinhood platform and buy Tesla. Right?
I know.
Like,
no,
daily, day over day.
Listen, I remember, I can't wait till someone comes into my house. So this is what ended up happening, folks. And I said this, but I'll just refresh you. This is what ended up happening at the high of Bitcoin. What ended up happening, Ellie is 21. She came in with some of her friends, and they're on their phone, right? And they're saying, Tom, look how much money I'm up. I says, what are you up on? Bitcoin. And I says, oh, yeah, when did you buy Bitcoin? Oh, I bought it last week. And I'm trying to figure out, I'm saying, you have $20,000, man? And and so what ended up happening, it's the same as that this fractional deal. You could buy, like, the, you know, little tiny fractions
right.
of it. You know what
That's
I mean?
Right. Yeah, and it brings in a lot of new money.
Yeah, so we'll see when the next person comes in the house and tells me that they just bought a fractional share of, I haven't had that yet. Hey, let me switch gears on you, right?
Hey, man.
You know, let's talk China, the Hong Kong deal, because it seems like this is pretty intense, man. I mean, I remember very well, folks, when Hong Kong opened up, and that was no doubt a huge deal, and China opened up in general, do you know what I mean?
Right.
But the more I keep looking at this, man, I mean, they're not only coming down hard on Hong Kong, you know, they had, like, pre-elections to figure out who to put against, you know, the other party, And, I mean, Lamb is out there saying this, well, that might be against the law, too. I mean, this is like Hong Kong's turning into China like in about a heartbeat. But it's like, what do you think's going to play out there, man? I mean, economically.
I think, you know, it's definitely a net negative for the region. You know, a lot of commerce flowed through Hong Kong, and the current administration appears bent on treating basically Hong Kong economically as just like mainland China, which is really not something the Chinese wanted. You know, Hong Kong was kind of their conduit to the rest of the world. I mean, they did a lot of trade too, but Hong Kong with the banking and the free flow of money and everything. And now clearly the Trump administration has wanted to change that since the Chinese current stance with Hong Kong, and almost as a way of retaliation. And, you know, it just gets into a game of one-upsmanship, then the Chinese will retaliate. But if we shut down Hong Kong and if we treat it as we've treated mainland China, I mean, that's going to, right off the top, you know, that's billions with a B, net negative for that region. Money doesn't flow as freely. You've got, you know, the tariff situation. Just, it opens up.
And you know,
a lot of retaliation for China.
Well, what's going to get intriguing here, too, it opens up the whole aspect that, okay, so United States, we believe in freedom, democracy, and all this, okay? We know what China always has been, that's for sure. I guess the real question is going to be, like, when you start going forward, it's like, okay, so now they shut down Hong Kong. We know that they're in Africa, they're in a lot of different places. You know, then it's going to be, like, kind of one of these deals that, like, okay, is this really going to be a Cold War battle as we're going forward? And then
that's
what
right.
are our big companies going to do about it? Because everything still comes from China. I mean, that hasn't stopped
right.
at all.
Yeah, the immediate economic impact from a commerce perspective with Hong Kong and China, you know, you're going to have a lot of your tech companies that would set up in Hong Kong as a way of kind of working through and around China. They're going to pull, and some have already said, they'll pull back from the region, right? So, you know, your tech companies that had a presence in Hong Kong as a proxy for having a presence in China will pull back. Again, that's a net negative for the Chinese, but that's also less revenue for U.S. tech. And I think it just, these things cascade from there, right?
Yeah.
Like, this started out as, you know, the Chinese with the security law, which we may disagree with, you know, on principal grounds, but it just escalates and escalates from there, and it spirals out of control.
Well, I'm so glad you said that, because you know what I've realized forever? That, you know, like, what happens, folks, is that if you start a fight, then 2 years later, you forget what the fight would even started about, because it can escalate so dramatically.
That's right.
And that's where we are with that. I mean, that's, you know, that seems it. Like, okay, you want to fight? Well, guess what? You're going to have a fight, and then we forget what the beginning of it was about, and because then everything starts getting thrown into it, man.
That's right, man.
Pretty well.
And there's no winners, right?
I mean,
let me get a political statement here. Clearly, we have principles that we stand for, and I'm proud of those.
Right.
But on the flip side, you know, it's going to continue to escalate, and nobody wins.
Wow.
Certainly not the markets. Hey, man, we'll be watching Netflix.
We'll be
can't
watching
wait to talk
Netflix,
about it next week.
Man.
Tesla earnings release next week, too, man. Can't wait.
Big time. You have a great one, safe one.
You
we'll
too, man.
Speak
Stay cool.
Tuesday. Thanks, man.
Bye, buddy.
Stay right there, folks. Come right back.